Hi, I'm Jim McCord, Product Marketing Engineer at Keysight Technologies. In this video, we show you an LTE-Advanced carrier aggregation demonstration of channel state information using Keysight's UXM wireless test set. Akhilesh Daniel, our product manager, is here to show how to perform the CSI measurements. He will also show you the impact of channel quality on data throughput. As in the other videos in this series, the demo setup uses a commercially available LTE-Advanced Category 4 device. Over to you, Akhilesh.
Thanks, Jim. Channel state information is very important for mobile networks. A UE reporting incorrect CSI, which is CQI, PMI, or RI, will cause misuse of valuable resource allocations, either with excessively protected data or higher than optimum retransmissions. So ensuring that the UE reports CSI correctly is vitally important. We'll start with the UXM's blur versus time measurement. The OTA DL trace shows the downlink IP data throughput over time, and the OTA UL trace shows the uplink. With no channel impairments enabled, this device achieves 145 megabits per second on the downlink and 25 megabits per second on the uplink. I'll select the RMC configuration. You can see the allocation tables are set to provide the reported CQI values. The allocated values can also be set by the user. Now I'll navigate to the CQI histograms screen. We see a CQI value of 15 and an RI value of 2. This means the UE is reporting that the channel can support two code words with a CQI of 15 for the maximum throughput that can be delivered. Now let's see how that changes. I'll select the primary cell and introduce some fading. You can see a range of CQI values depending on the faded signal. The rank index shows that two code words can still be supported. Next, I'll add a bit of Gaussian noise. You can see the results are different. The measurement results now show that for some occurrences, the UE can support two code words with a CQI of around 10, and for other occurrences, it can support only one code word with a CQI of 15. If we come back to the blur versus throughput screen, we can see the impact on throughput. The throughput is diminished as expected. Now, if we disable the noise and the fading, you can see the throughput recovers to the previous levels, which verifies that the device is responding well to the channel state. Back to you, Jim.
Thanks, Akhilesh. We just saw how easy it is to perform CSI measurements with the UXM and validate that the device is reporting correctly. Having integrated AWGN and fading greatly simplifies the test engineer's benchtop, and the UXM's large touch interface enables you to quickly gain new insights about your device's performance. With the UXM, you can assess your design readiness with greater confidence. Is your design ready? For more information, visit the website on your screen. Thanks for watching.